Thanks everybody for coming. My name is Tom Moser. I'm a senior program manager on the Azure Information Protection team, and I'm going to talk to you guys briefly today about our Microsoft Information Protection SDK. So just so I'm aware, is everybody familiar with either Azure Information Protection or Azure Rights Management or Active Directory Rights Management? Okay. So the SDK is an extension of the work we've been doing around RMS and then AIP for the last few years, where we are able to protect data on your devices at rest, data in transit. So I protect a file, I classify a file. Wherever that file travels, we apply protection to it. And if it's on a flash drive that I lose over here in the convention center, out in the parking lot, nobody has access to the data unless I've given them access to that file specifically. So this slide here highlights our vision for information protection as a whole across Microsoft. And so you can see we've got some fragmentation here across the different areas of our technologies that cover different platforms. So under devices, we have Windows Information Protection. You'll see that under Office 365, we have O365 DLP, Advanced Data Governance. Azure Information Protection bridges the gap between our on-prem existing file servers and SharePoint servers and Office 365. So we're able to apply classification, apply protection to those documents. So that as they traverse between those two locations or externally, the documents remain protected. And then we have cloud app security that bridges this other kind of smaller gap between our cloud and third-party SaaS applications, as well as Office 365 to protect our content as it's leaving our organization or traveling through sanctioned SaaS applications. What you probably notice is that we don't have a cohesive solution today that covers all of this, right? So there's no one platform or one method of addressing every area of this story. And that's what we're hoping to address with the Microsoft Information Protection SDK. We'll allow our developers, we'll allow customers, ISVs, first party at Microsoft, as well as third party. Karnik, one of my colleagues, will be here later today to talk about what we're doing as far as our third party ecosystem with Digital Guardian, Varonis, Symantec, and several other partners integrating with our information protection story. And I'll show you guys exactly what that means for your enterprise, for your either third-party products or your own in-house products that you're building today. So the idea is that we'll drive consistency across enterprise environments. And so by using the SDK, we'll enable you to, and sorry, this is kind of an eye chart, but to integrate with all the different components you have today in your enterprise. So today you probably have if you're an O365 customer, you've got O365, and you might have a client or server DLP-based solution. You probably have a CASB. We're hoping that with our SDK, we can get all of these companies to build a common data classification, a data protection taxonomy and service, so you don't have to use different point solutions. What you probably see today is that you have one vendor, one partner who might use one classification or protection method, and then you have another who uses something different, and everybody wants to use their own method. We're trying to unify, trying to bring everybody together so that we can have one common data classification taxonomy and protection method to bring all these different products together to keep your sensitive information from traveling to places it shouldn't. So our vision for the SDK is that we'll drive a consistent experience for information protection. This is really important. I've been working in the information protection team at Microsoft for 2.5 years now, and one of the biggest problems we find is that AIP works great in Office, but as soon as we start to talk about other applications, think of like your CAD CAM or your design or even your PDF readers, it starts to fail a little bit because there's not that compatibility with both the classification experience and RMS protection. The SDK will help to drive that consistency across all those platforms. We're hoping that then that will broaden the reach of information protection capabilities so that you guys can continue to protect what's important to your organizations rather than just saying, well, it doesn't work with PDF, so I guess we're done. This is one of the big takeaways, and we've been really driving this with our ISV partners, is that we want to treat both Microsoft first-party applications and third-party partners as equals. We're not going to give anything to somebody internally at Microsoft or give anybody an edge at Microsoft that we don't also give to one of our partners. So our goal is that if McAfee or Sky High comes along and says, hey, we want to use this, we'll say, great, you're going to get the same thing that we give our MCAS team. So we're not giving anybody any advantages. We want to simplify the integration model. We have an SDK today for the old RMS platform. It's kind of complicated. It's not easy to start with. I tried. I quit. And so the new SDK is much simpler and easy to integrate into your own applications. It's cross-platform. So this SDK that we announced today, you can go to aka.ms/MIP SDK to start to take a look at that, is cross-platform. So we work today on all supported versions of Windows. We work on Mac OS High Sierra. We work on Ubuntu Linux and Debian Linux, Debian 9. And we'll have mobile support in the near future. And finally, and most importantly, is that we're looking to drive an industry standard for information protection. If you've looked at the data classification ecosystem out there, everybody has their own way of applying labels. A lot of companies actually, even if they have their own labeling, they still use Azure or AD Rights Management to actually apply protection. But everybody has their own different labeling taxonomy. And we're really trying to drive consistency because, quite frankly, nobody's going to be successful at data classification if we're all applying the classification in a different way. So looking more at the integration, so this is kind of a high-level overview of what the components of the SDK. I'll talk more about those in a minute here. But you can see that the different components of the SDK are targeted towards different platforms. So over here on the left side, you'll see that our core SDK is looking at applications like Office or a PDF reader, whether it's Adobe or Foxit, Outlook, and then anything of part of the 3MF consortium. And on the right side, we look at our service applications. So we're talking about Digital Guardian, Forcepoint, any type of server DLP or even client DLP is out there would use our file API, and I'll cover that more in a minute. This breaks down the SDK into a little bit more detail, showing that we have really three main components of the SDK. So we've got this classification SDK, which is coming soon. We have our labeling and protection SDK and our file SDK or API. So what we can do with each of those, I'll just run through them, is we have first the policy API. So this is going to be, for most of you, an important part because it exposes your organizational classification taxonomy to your applications, and it exposes them in a consistent manner. So with the policy API, I can, for example, display the list of labels that my organization's defined in my line of business application. And then when a user clicks that label, I can then call that API to compute the action that should be taken. So an example of an action would be that I want to apply a header, a footer, a watermark, some metadata, and protection. And that API is going to tell you, hey, application, go do all these things. And then it's up to you as a software developer to actually implement that action. We also have our protection API. So this is what we're going to expose to allow you to either protect files or to decrypt files. Typically, this will be if you own a file format. So let's say you're a 3D printing company. You would use this to be able to apply protection to your own file format and then to read that file format and then display it in your own application. And the rights enforcement. So if you're familiar with our rights management service or the protection component of Azure Information Protection, it's able to enforce rights at the application level. So if I open up a document in Word, for example, the owner of that document can restrict my ability to print or my ability to save. And so you, using this API as the software developer, would have to enforce that in your own application. But up until that's opened, it's going to be encrypted, secure, and only an authorized individual will be able to open it. And finally, but definitely not least, is our file API. So the file API is what most of our partners are going to use, at least in the beginning. In the file API, we're providing an abstraction of both the policy and the protection API. And by that, what I mean is it's able to expose the labels that are available to your organization. It's able to allow you to apply labels, read labels on documents. But what we've done is a lot of the work around well-known file formats. So Office files, PDF files, P files. There's a whole other list that I can't remember off the top of my head. But you'll essentially be able to pass in a file, pass in a label ID, and we'll do all the work for you. We'll apply the metadata. We'll apply the content marking if we can. We can't for all formats. We'll apply the RMS protection or the AIP protection. And that's it. File, label, and it's done. Now, on the other side of that is a vendor who might make a server DLP product. If I get a file, so a file comes across my DLP product, I need to inspect it, I'll be able to natively go to that file and read the label off the file. Now, the other part of that is, as that DLP vendor, I'll also be able to expose in my application, in my management interface, all the labels in your organization. So you'll set up some service principle. That service principle goes out to the Azure Information Protection Service, or the MIP service, pulls down all my labels, and they're just exposed. So now I can start to create rules where the predicates are something like, if the data is classified as highly confidential, take an action. And that all becomes native across all these platforms. And so with the SDK, what we're really striving to do is, one, enable all of our partners to be able to make that experience native for you guys so you don't have to hack around and copy GUIDs and things into your rules, and then also to allow you to enlighten your own applications for information protection. So I'll go through some examples here of each of the APIs and what you might use them for. The policy API, we think, is primarily going to be used by client-facing applications. So the first example I have here is that your company builds 3D design software. So you're building 3D design software for the automotive industry, and your automotive customers are concerned about information protection. You would expose a labeling interface. They can click a button. Your application would then be able to apply that metadata to your own file format in such a way that it's readable by the API, that other applications can consume it, and then when other people open it up, they see that label exposed in the application interface. I mentioned this one a moment ago, but the next example would be that your company builds a DLP product. You could use the policy API to expose the available labels for your customer's tenant in their own service. And then the last one here is that your customer builds a well-known PDF authoring application. So a common ask is that PDFs are able to, I mean, because there's office documents and there's PDFs, and then there's kind of everything else over here as far as document types. So the last one here would be that you make a PDF authoring application, you'd be able to expose your data classification taxonomy in that application, and as I'm authoring that PDF, I can apply a label, and everything else just happens for my user. So the really important takeaway here is that your enabling your users to make a great security decision based just on the label, and everything else to them is transparent, which we all know makes great security control. So the protection API. Some examples here, again, going back to 3D printing, is if I'm a 3D design or a 3D printing company and I own a proprietary file format, I could leverage the protection API to protect certain parts of that file so that I could restrict a user from printing my 3D file, right? So let's say it's a prototype and I want to make sure it doesn't get leaked to my competitor and printed on their 3D printer. I could restrict that right with the protection API in my own application. E-discovery software. So this is a really big issue today with protection in Azure Information Protection is that data for most of our third-party e-discovery vendors is opaque. They can't reason over it. So lawyers love it when you say, I don't know what's in that file. So now they have to look through thousands of encrypted files because they don't have a way with their tool to actually import it and look into it. So we see the protection API is also being used by e-discovery vendors to go through and decrypt all that information, be able to reason over it, and then provide it in an output PST or file as part of litigation. And then finally, we have the file API. So this is primarily what we'll see our customers and partners using that are developing line of business applications. So an example here is that all of you probably have some line of business application that's able to export Excel spreadsheets, export PDFs. So what this would enable your organization to do is say, well, on export, I know that this particular table has highly confidential information. Maybe it's an HR database. Maybe it's my client identifiers. On export, we could simply say, hey, MIP SDK, apply protection to this document, or apply a label to this document that then applies protection. And on download, the user will receive an encrypted file that they're able to open in Office, and they can't share outside of your organization. So it helps with that data leakage. You may own or be developing a CASB application that needs to reason over Office and PDF files. The file API would help with that. You could just pass into the API, read the label off of the file, and then make decisions based on just that label. So I don't have to do any content inspection. I don't have to worry about what's in the contents. We assume the user did the right thing by labeling it, and then we take action based solely on the label. And finally, and similar to the previous point, is that your company owns or builds a service-based DLP solution that monitors endpoints, services, or cloud services, and again, you'd be able to just read files directly off those machines and then get the label and take some action based on the contents. All right, so if you're interested in grabbing our SDK, it's available today at aka.ms/mipsdk. If any of you are responsible for deploying Azure Information Protection either in your own organization or for any of your customers, you can head out to aka.ms/AIPYammer. That's our public Yammer group where you're engaged with people like myself and Kardik. We're both on the AIP product team, and there's several others. You can ask questions. We have great customer feedback, great partner feedback. We'll answer questions on there. And you know, we encourage you to go sign up. There's about 3,000 people in that community today. If anybody is interested, I'm about out of time. If anybody's interested, I'll be at the booth here pretty much all day today. I have a C# example that I can show you using our SDK and how you can read and apply some labels. And I'd love to talk more about that and where we're at, and then also what we're doing as we approach general availability in the next couple of months. All right, well, thanks for your time. Does anybody have any questions, anything I can answer? Perfect. Thanks, everybody.